Hey guys, this is Swagat and you are watching Gadgets Buster, and today we will talk about the most common tech myths that we all usually have in our day-to-day life. So let's just begin. The first tech myth is charging your phone overnight damages its battery life. So is it true? No, it's actually not. In our old smartphones, not smartphones, in our old phones like Nokia phones and the previous models, in that phones, if you overcharge them, there is a chance that their battery will explode or the phone will get damaged. But in this new smartphones, all the smartphones get a feature like automatic cutoff when it is full charged. Lithium-ion batteries are not like that, in that they get this protection. Even the chargers have the protection, so you should not worry about that. And you can charge your phone overnight, and some say that it will not damage your phone but reduce your battery life. That is also not true. That is, till now there is no proof that the battery life is reduced for that. So you can charge your phone overnight, and when you wake up, you will get 100% charge. That's no problem in that. The next myth is that the more megapixel a camera has, the better the camera is. But this is not the fact actually. The thing is that you should consider about the megapixel as well as the sensor that the camera uses and the aperture of the lens. So these are the some important things that you should consider when buying a camera, or even if you are comparing two smartphone cameras. So these are the things you should take care of. That is not only the megapixel. Megapixel just the resolution. It means more megapixel means the image could be bigger, but if the sensor is not good, the image sensor, then the photo quality will not be good. So you should consider about that, and also you should consider about the aperture. If it has a better aperture, then it will take better quality photos. So you should take care of these things before buying a camera or before buying some smartphone. Next is pulling your pen drive without ejecting it will cause file loss. But I don't think so. That is not necessary. Means if you pull your pen drive from the computer without ejecting it, your files will get deleted or you will have a loss, file loss. That is not the case. But the thing is that if there is some file transfer is going on from your computer to pen drive or from the pen drive to the computer, if you are moving some file, and meanwhile you pull the pen drive knowingly or accidentally, in that case the file loss may take place, means the copying procedure may be get stopped at the half, and then if you are moving the file, in that case you may also get the file loss. But simply if you are not doing anything and pulling the pen drive without any ejecting, that is not necessary. Nothing will happen. Just try it. Next myth is that Mac computers doesn't get virus. But that's not the case. Mac computers do get attacked by the virus, not as frequent as the Windows get, but still Mac computers get attacked. Actually, most of the viruses are made for Windows systems that doesn't run on Mac PCs. Why? Because most of the population uses Windows PCs, so in that the creator of the virus and their people, they need to attack more people. This myth usually arises in the beginning stage when Apple claimed that it doesn't get affected by the virus. But in that time, thousands of Apple Mac computers get attacked by Trojan viruses, and hence it proved it wrong. And another thing is that the Mac computers does get some built-in security features like the firewall protection and other protections that is better than as compared to the Windows. So Mac users, you are also required to take care of your laptop or PCs. because they may also get attacked by the virus. The last myth is that if you get more bars in your cell phone, then the call quality will be better. But this is not true actually. In this, you may get full bars, full signal strength in your smartphone. You can see the signal strength, you can check that. But the thing is that it depends on the network congestion. That means the number of users in your area. Suppose your area has one tower and the number of people in your area is more. So more people are getting connected with that tower, and if suppose the tower reaches maximum capacity, then you may experience call drops. But in another area, you can get the same signal strength, but the population is less and less number of people are connected with that tower. So there is less network congestion and you will not experience any call drops and may have better call quality even with the lesser signal strength. So that's the thing you need to consider about. It's not that like more signal bars you will get in your smartphone and that means you will get better call quality, or that is not the case. That's all. Thank you for watching. I hope you all like my video. Please give it a thumbs up and please do subscribe it, and also please comment in the comment box. You can also share it to show your friends, and I will also bring such videos every week. Thank you.